really pursuing music, I wanted to really mark my independence. So I decided to make my stage name INEDX, and it was just, for me, it meant, this is what I'm doing. Whoever's behind me is behind me. If they're not crying, this is what I'm doing. This is my mark. And it's become so much more for me. Like, the X means so much to me after going through so much. It means being unstoppable, it means being undefined, it means being, you know, empowered. And, you know, I always say to my fans, and I always say, you know, you are my team. We are Team X, and we are in this together.
Well, what kind of music can the audience expect from you?
I, right now, am really focusing on making pop music. I love pop. So, and I love being able to touch, you know, different people, different races. And I think a lot of different people listen to pop music. But I'm very inspired by all genres. So, you know, I try to mix in some, you know, Middle Eastern sounds, or try to mix in some, you know, R&B sounds or vibes, you know. But I'm just really, I'm focusing on the pop, but I'm really exploring my artistry and trying new things.
How did you get your start in music?
Starting in music was hard. It wasn't easy, you know, because I was born in Brooklyn, but at the time, I was living in Connecticut with my family, and really, there was no opportunity around me. So I just started working with whatever musicians I could find, and, you know, getting the studios I could find, and getting vocal coaching and everything that I could, because I never had that as a little girl. So I just wanted to really get the training and really learn the craft. And in the industry, I started as an intern. So when I was 19, I was an intern at Island Def Jam, and it was a very interesting experience. Very interesting experience. So yeah, I started as an intern, actually. So literally started from the bottom. And, you know, I've been working my way up ever since, and I will not stop until I reach.
Is there anybody in particular that you go to or that you look up to?
I definitely, when I'm feeling low on energy and needing inspiration, I like to surround myself with artists, and you know, I study a lot. So I study my favorite artists. I watch, you know, my favorite artist is Michael Jackson, so I'll watch like videos of Michael. Like, just different artists who I can really learn from. And when I'm low on inspiration, I'll do that. Or, you know, my main role model is my mother. So whenever I'm really low on energy, she'll inspire me and just give me everything that I need.
Walk us through what it's like to be you, your regular day. What's your routine like?
I make sure I work out every day. That's important, or I try to work out every day. But, you know, sometimes scheduling is so crazy that I can't even fit it in. But, I mean, you know, every day working on the craft, you know, something I take seriously is, you know, I believe in the 10,000 hour rule. So if you work on something for 10,000 hours, you master it. So with me, my main passion is singing, songwriting, but singing mainly. So I devote at least 30 minutes to practicing my vocals every day.
So all women have insecurities, whether it's physical or just, you know, being in a funk. How do you pull yourself out of it?
On my low days, I mean, you know, I'm human, I have low days. And on my low days, I really like to just, like, relax, go to the spa, just really get in my, you know, this industry, the business, everything gets so overwhelming and so stressful sometimes. And, you know, sometimes you just feel like you're caving in and you just want to hide under a rock, you know? But it's like, I try to really just not dwell too long on things that are upsetting me, and talk to people who help me cope, and who, you know, I believe in asking for help and getting help when needed.
Do you have any advice, any tips, any like go-to exercises that you can share with us?
I also have those days, by the way. I just want to let you know that I do. I really do. So it's a journey. You know what I mean? Like, I've been on this journey, my music journey, my health journey go hand in hand. Especially this last year, you know, I really started taking it to the whole next level because I was diagnosed with MS in last July. And I started really wanting to know how are all the ways that I can better my body and make sure that I'm at my best.
For our readers that aren't familiar with MS, can you give us a little briefing on what the disease is and how you've dealt with it?
Sure. So yeah, I was diagnosed with multiple sclerosis in July, and I started losing the vision in my left eye. And for people who don't know, multiple sclerosis is an autoimmune disease, and your immune system attacks your nervous system. And yeah, I had an optic nerve attack. I started losing vision in my left eye, and it was the scariest experience of my life. Yes, thank God. I went to, you know, my mom was in Connecticut. I went to Yale University, and they healed me. spent 5 days, I was on steroid treatment, I came back and my vision is back 100%. And I started treatment in September, and you know, I'm under the supervision of some of the best in the country. So I like, thank God it all happened the way it happened. You know, God is good and everything happens for a reason. You know, at first when it happened to me, I was super upset. I was super sad for weeks, you know what I mean?
Did you have like a whammy?
Of course, because it's like, you know, at such a young age, how can this happen to me? Like, you never expect to have something like that. It's like, what, you know? Like, how is this happening? Why is this happening? Why me? All of that. And I really, you know, I had to cope with it because it was a traumatic experience. And I had to cope with it, and I'm not gonna lie to you, I'm still coping with it, you know what I mean? I'm still learning about it, and I'm still asking people about it. But for me, it's important that I wanna show people that, yeah, I have this, but I'm still killing it. And like, we all have something, you know, everybody has something, whether it be physical, mental, whatever it may be, everyone has something. And I think it's important to see, no matter what you have, what you're dealing with, you could still kill it, because we all can, and I want to show people that, you know? So
yeah, no, that's why
I'm working so hard to just be the best I can be in mind, soul, and body, so that I can really, really embody that.
It's the motto. So at Attract, we like to showcase a woman's individuality. When do you feel the most attractive?
When do I feel the most attractive? You know what, honestly, lately, it's really interesting. Lately, like, I would say normally that when I'm all glammed up, I feel the most beautiful, but honestly, lately, when I don't have any makeup on, like, I've been enjoying it.
Wait, I wanna know what we can expect from your music career.
Oh yeah, I'm super excited because I've been working so hard on all the music lately, and I've just been in the studio nonstop and just making so much music. I'm working on an EP, like a visual EP. So I'm trying to have visuals with it and make it sort of documentary status, and I want to release that in fall. But definitely we're working on it right now, getting the summer singles together and putting that out. You know, I'm not trying to rush anything because I believe in taking your time. I have a lot of music that I haven't released yet because, you know, it's like I'm really picky about what I put out and really showcasing who I am as an artist, as a woman, as a person, the best way I can. And I have a lot of music videos of music that I haven't released yet because I'm like, timing. Everything's about timing. When the time is right, it'll all happen. So it's all about strategy, execution, and we're all getting all that together, but I can't wait to show how I've been evolving and where I'm at, and just, I really want the music to touch people and people to feel it, feel me, and relate and all that. So, you know, in due time, it's all coming, but I promise, like, 2017, we're coming like crazy with music, like, it's crazy.
Great. And tell us where we can follow you on social media.
So yeah, you can follow me everywhere. follow me everywhere. What, Instagram, Facebook, Snapchat, Twitter, YouTube, SoundCloud, Spotify, all those things. So find me everywhere, Inez X, I N A